next guests are here to tell you about a first for Waltham that's coming up. And it is strictly a children's thing. And I think you're just going to love visiting the Waltham Common on June 23rd, because there will be lots of children. It's the first annual Waltham Children's Business Fair. And with me is Fiona Mamai. And did I say that correctly? Waltham Children's Business
Fair, but it happens to be the second.
The second annual. So we missed that, didn't we?
Yes.
Okay. So the first annual, was that also on the Common?
No.
I didn't think so. It was a much smaller event.
Yes.
This is going to be big.
It's going to be big. We're going to have about 50 different businesses, and all are solely owned by the children. The children are going to create the businesses. They're going to do the selling and the marketing on their own. It's really exciting because we have all these different businesses by kids, and we just can't wait for that day. Yeah.
And so, just a little bit of background.
Yes.
You and I met when I actually called you.
Yes.
Because of your art gallery, and I wanted to learn more about the art gallery.
Yes.
You said, wait a minute, I have something else to tell you.
Yeah.
And you told me about the Children's Business Fair, and I thought that was amazing.
Thank you.
And you are now officially a nonprofit organization.
Yes.
If there are people that want to help out, be involved,
they're very welcome.
Be part of your board of directors as you grow, I think that will be wonderful.
That will be amazing because Mamai Art Gallery started as a jewelry making. I just made my jewelry and sold it to people. Then I realized it would be better if I share my art more with other people. So we came up with the parent-child art sessions.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, we have realized that some parents are going to find it hard to leave their homes. So what I have done is create some events that will actually push parents to work with their children, even if they do not come to Mamai Art Gallery physically. And this is through the business fairs, because this is going to be our second business fair. And then we also have the International Children's Art Contest. I have children from all over the world making paintings and drawings, and then they send them on to our web page where we do online voting. And
so they would download it onto your web page, your website.
Yeah, we send out a link that is going to be used on that for that particular event, and then parents encourage their friends to vote for their kids, and then we have judges. These two ladies, Nicole and Lizzie, are among the judges for the international.
And so tell us about the deadline for the art contest.
The art contest is I usually start taking applications in November.
Okay.
For the next year.
So what people should do is go to your website.
Yes.
And go to your Facebook page and like
just
your Facebook page.
Yeah.
Because that's going to be coming up a little bit later.
Yes.
But we want to talk about what's coming up in just a short period of time.
Yes. And, that's
and it's a great logo, Waltham Children's Business Fair.
Yes.
And so enough of you.
Exactly.
No, this is a children's thing. You've encouraged them to take responsibility
and
use their creativity. So you have some rules too, Fiona.
Yes,
that parents cannot be helicopter parents.
No.
They can't be hovering over you that day.
No.
They're just going to be walking the grounds, and they're going to be doing other things.
Exactly.
But you're going to be doing your own businesses. So why don't I talk to Nicole? And Nicole, what are you encouraged about with the Children's Business Fair? What do you hope that this accomplishes for you and the other children?
I hope it shows the other children that you can do whatever you put your mind to, and I hope hope it shows entrepreneur skills that are in them, and so they can show their parents that they can do stuff on their own.
Absolutely. And so you've done stuff on your own, haven't you?
Yeah.
Tell me what you've done on your own.
Me and Lizzie have written 3 books, actually.
Can we see those? Now, see, you're a helicopter parent.
I know. Sometimes it just happens.
See, it's the force of nature of parenting. She reached for the books, and I was talking to you.
I know.
So,
and that's what we don't want on that day. I know.
But so tell me, Nicole, which books have you written, or have you always collaborated with Lizzie?
Well, when we're writing our books, we share our ideas sometimes,
right?
And sometimes one of us helps the other, like with ideas or. Yeah.
Yeah, or the whole writing process. So you two are writing partners, aren't you?
Yeah.
Creative writing partners. So, Lizzie, the book that you have, The Waterfall, is your own book?
Yes.
And so did you do this by yourself, or did you collaborate?
We
collaborated.
Nicole helped me out, yeah.
And tell me about Waterfall.
It's basically about this book about this girl who gets, like, magical powers, and she wants more because she doesn't feel like she's perfect the way she is. And when things go wrong with her powers, she realizes that she's supposed to be who she is, and she's very unique in her own way.
And we all have what's perfect about us, and we all have our little pitfalls, don't we? Can I see that? Thank you. I'm just gonna hold this up. This is a very colorful book, and there's Lizzie Lopez on the back, and I have to say, this is not just a little book. You've got several pages of this story, and Lizzie has a friend who travels with her through this adventure of looking for perfection, right? That's wonderful. So are you going to be selling your book that day?
Yes.
Oh, that's great.
They're actually online, too.
That's great. And Nicole,
yes.
Tell us about your books.
Well, I've written one book called The American Dream, which is about this zebra family that comes to America to pursue their American dream. But they realize that there's no other zebras in America, so their teacher shows them that they're unique the way they are, and that sometimes so kind of the moral of the story is,
let me have the book. I will tell you the moral of this story, that you can be unique and you can still fit in, right?
Yeah.
And you can adapt to anything that you put your mind to. Am I right?
Yeah.
And I see the zebras are at the farm and they're having pancakes.
Yeah.
I didn't know zebras had pancakes, my favorite food. But this is really wonderful. And so you wrote this book,
yes.
And there's your photo. And, you know, this gives parents out there a little encouragement, and the children out there encouragement that they can write a book. They can tell their own story, can't they?
Yeah.
And what is this other book?
This book is called Belle's Life Lesson, which is about this rabbit that is playing with her friend when a tornado comes, and her friend is blown away. And then there's another person in her neighborhood who's lost their mother in their tornado. So kind of the moral of the story is that even if you've lost something you really love, you should keep going on, because that's what they would have wanted.
Because that forms friendships too, right?
Yeah.
And you can find other people and other bunnies that are in the same position that you're in. And yeah, absolutely. And that kind of happened in my life, because my mom had Alzheimer's and she couldn't remember things. And eventually she passed away and went to heaven. And I thought, oh, I'm an orphan. I'm an adult orphan. But you know what I found out? That there were other people who had moms and dads that they took care of that had Alzheimer's. So I wasn't alone in that. I was in this big pool of people that also had that loss, you know? So you grow from that and you help people along. And so we do a walk every year for Alzheimer's and raise money. And the little bunny found somebody that she could be friends with and help. So that's amazing. That's amazing. I'm so proud of you. So what other things do you think the children will be doing that day? Crafts? And tell me.
There are some craft businesses, but there's also food businesses.
Really?
And services businesses, too. So there's a whole variety of businesses that are going to be attending.
So you're going to have a table together, or are you going to share a table?
Yeah.
And then some children will have tables with,
for example, their best friends, and their business is called Mythic Sensations.
Yeah.
Their books are online. You can find them on Lulu.com and Amazon.com and Barnes & Noble. All you have to do is type in The Waterfall by Lizzie Lopez or The American Dream by Nicole Tokahira.
Can they also go to your Facebook page and get a link?
They have their own Facebook page.
Oh,
which...
excuse me.
Yeah.
You really are business women.
Yeah,
so you have a Facebook page?
Yeah.
And you have a Facebook page?
It's the same.
So you're writing partners, of course.
Yes.
And so what's the Facebook page? So if people want to go and find out how to buy a book.
Their Facebook page is Lisnik Sensations.
Okay.
And so basically, I let them do their writing. Like they just sit down and scribble their stuff.
And that's what this whole event is about.
All about.
Letting the children be creative.
Exactly. Because
letting them do their
no
life.
Matter.
So it's going to be June 20th.